Today, we're diving into a crucial topic of the rapidly evolving embedded systems market. With increasing demands for efficiency, performance, and scalability, choosing the right technologies for your embedded project is more challenging than ever. To shed light on this, we're speaking with Olivier from Slint and Miłosz from KDAB. We've brought them together to explain why Slint with C++ could be a great choice for your next embedded project.
I'm Olivier, and I'm one of the technical co-founders of Slint.
And I'm Miłosz. I'm software engineering and project manager at KDAB. So, Olivier, maybe you could start with you telling us about what Slint is and how it can help in embedded software development.
Yeah. So, Slint is a UI framework. It uses a declarative domain-specific language. And that language is both self-contained and statically typed, meaning that we catch error at compile time and we can easily integrate with tooling like live preview or design tool. We compile the Slint language to native code, so C++, which means that it is fast to start and uses very little memory at runtime. So we can target with Slint MCUs with only a few hundred kilobytes of RAM, but Slint can also scale up and use accelerated GPUs. Slint is also an open source toolkit, so you can look at the source code, investigate it, and even fix it if you need to. You can also ask services companies such as KDAB to help you with bug fixes and or features. So Miłosz, could you give us some insights about using C++ in embedded software context?
Sure. C++ is quite a popular choice for embedded software. Particularly if you already have a code base written in C++, you definitely want to reuse it. So in this case, you don't have much choice. You probably want to stay with it, right? But even if you're starting a new project, there are reasons to go with C++. The ecosystem is really mature. It has been around for decades. If you count C as a base for C++, it stretches back even more. So there's a lot of effort put into making this work, and big companies are basing their products on C++, so we can be sure that the ecosystem is well supported. And even though it's been for such a long time, I wouldn't say it's stagnant, particularly after C++ 11. There are new versions of the language. They are getting modernized. So you are looking at a stable, mature, yet modern ecosystem. That's something that's a good base to base your product on. And when we are talking about an embedded context, so the performance is important, right? You are coding for lower powered devices. You don't have beefy CPUs and GPUs usually. So you want something that will let you squeeze all the performance you get. And C++ is the thing for you because it's close to the metal, right? There are no heavy abstractions. If you know what you're doing, you can get a lot out of it for the little power you have on the device. There is also a large ecosystem of libraries that you can tap into for all sorts of things. Graphics, data structures, networking, multimedia. There's lots of it. You can choose from many of these. Many of these are open source. They're low cost to use. And another thing is that it's still a popular language. Maybe not as popular as, say, web technologies, but still, there are many people who know how to write C++, so it may be easier for you to hire for it. Yes, these are the reasons that you could still go with C++, even for a new project. And on top of that, we found at KDAB, while working on an electric vehicle charger project, that it's really nice to work with Slint. Slint has a great API for that. You can read about this project in the description below. So, Olivier, let's say I choose Slint for my next embedded project. What are some trade-offs and challenges that I should be aware of?
Yeah, so as with every technology choice, there are trade-offs, there are negative points. So one of them is that Slint is a fairly new framework, so it doesn't have a very big community yet. That said, the community is growing and we see every day more and more users and also feature implemented by the community. Another thing is that Slint is using C++ 20, which might be a bit too recent if you're using an old toolchain. It might be an opportunity to upgrade your toolchain and enjoy the new feature of C++. And also the Slint declarative language, you will need to learn and to get familiar with it. This is not much more difficult than with other APIs of other framework. And especially with the tooling that we have, it's fairly easy. We have extension for Visual Studio Code and other editors. And you can have auto-completion and things like that, which makes it really easy to get familiar with the language. Miłosz, can you tell us if there is any trade-off in using C++?
Yeah, same as you said. There are trade-offs with every technology, so with C++ alike. The one I would first is that C++ is a very powerful language that gives you bare access to your hardware and won't stop you from shooting yourself in the foot. The memory safety is a big topic recently, and C++ is inherently not a safe language, memory safe language. So you have to be aware of that. There are ways to mitigate that, like sanitizers that many companies are pushing, which are essentially ways to statically analyze your code for more subtle mistakes. Also, you can use the standard library of the language to avoid using, say, naked pointers and use smart pointers instead that are way safer. Another thing is tooling. There is tons of tooling for C++, but it's quite a fragmented landscape. You don't have, like, for example, with Rust, the build system or the package manager. You have choices. You have to make choices. Most people use CMake as their build system, but there are other choices. For package management, when you want to pull third-party code, you may use Cullen, you may use VCPackage. They all have their pros and cons, so you have to evaluate that for your project. Hiring for C++, I said before that it is somewhat easy, but also definitely harder than for web technologies. So you have to be aware of that. Easier than for more esoteric languages, but harder than more popular things. And libraries, the ecosystem of third-party libraries. There's lots of them, but they might be sometimes difficult to interoperate, particularly if they have to do asynchronous operations. They may have different ideas on how to do this, and likely your embedded application has a UI, so it has to all interact with the event loop of your application, and it has to work together. And Slint has an answer for that in the form of the platform API. Olivier, can you tell us more about this?
Sure. Slint by default supports the major platform, but we also offer a platform API which allows you to take full control over the event loop. And you just give Slint events such as a mouse event or window event, and you tell Slint where to draw the next frame in an OpenGL texture or in a buffer for the software rendering. And Slint just takes care of this. This allows to be very flexible and to integrate Slint in virtually anything. So any platform or an existing application as a plugin, for example. Miłosz, you have experience mixing C++ and Slint. What can you tell us about it?
Yeah. So we did a couple of things already with Slint and C++. The biggest one is the one that I mentioned before, the electric vehicle charger project, where we implemented things like video playback, where we integrated it with a main loop of an already existing big code base backed by a large existing library. And it worked really well. The device is out there in the field And basing on this experience, we are now doing kind of a R&D project where we want to provide more of an out-of-the-box experience with Slint and C++ that other people could base their project on. Another thing that we are doing is putting Slint on Zephyr real-time operating system that is getting pretty popular recently. And we are using the Slint platform API for that. It works really well. Plus, all this work was done with the support of Slint team. They are very receptive to bug reports, bug fixes, and pull requests on their GitHub project. So thanks for that.
Thank you. This was also very nice working with your team. And thank you for all your pull requests and contributions.
We hope this video will help you in the decision-making process for choosing the right technology stack for your next embedded project. Slint and C++ are already powering devices in the field across the world.
You can visit our website to learn about more projects made with Slint and Slint itself.